Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. I haven't played this game for a little while, personally, although you've seen probably no break in the uploads. I've been trying to get ahead with the other game I've been playing, Lunar. Oh, God, and I'm knocking stuff around and stepping on cords. Oh, great fun. Just trying to get comfortable here. Okay, Ivo just got a jail. And I have a bunch of stuff for her to look at. Is but a scratch. I don't thought that was there the whole time, but I really just noticed it, you know, a few episodes ago. Could have been last episode.
Of course, statues will always be the first to lend their support when there's a revolution. I'm not sure who this statue's meant to be, but I'm certain that the council leader's people have defaced it.
Not exactly. Wilbur used it as the head. No, the arms or the legs, I forget which one, for his golem. The door we just came through.
I can't believe how the little rat boy got me out of jail. I think he must take after his uncle. If I do my job right, then soon I'm going to be an enemy of the state. And looking at this regime, I'd regard that as an honor.
Yeah, really.
If I do my job right, from celebrated hero to enemy of the state number 0.5. Steep career path for Wilbur.
Don't believe the hype.
A bucket with an evil-smelling, sticky, slimy substance. If I ever need anything like this, I'll know where to find it.
I think it's troll spit. No, I don't know. She go through here? What does she have to look at over here?
Oh, it's you.
Oh, that's me.
Working late, are we?
A merchant's work is never done. Now, if you don't mind, I'm off on holiday.
You're going on holiday? Who's going to look after business while you're gone?
Who takes care of business when you go on holiday?
We don't get many walk-in customers nowadays. We concentrate primarily on production. But when I get back, I'm going to talk to the council leader about opening up new markets.
interesting things you've got there. Oh, it's those slates that Wilbur and Esther and Gulliver. I remember the names. Wow. And even Ethel helped make these things.
And these are tribbles that you're selling?
Tribbles.
Fresh off the press, so to speak. The management's efforts have optimized production decisively.
Then one just needs to find someone who wants something like that.
I'm working on that. In my opinion, every school kid in the land needs a magic slate like this. I'm going to speak to the council leader of the merchants about that.
Okay, entrance to the underground. Where was it again?
What did you say? Where's the entrance to the underground?
I didn't say anything. You've got no business down there.
Where exactly have those fluffy things been manufactured?
Not in the underground.
Yeah.
And this privy doesn't lead there?
No.
Then may I use it? Or is the flush not working?
I don't know anything about any underground. I just want to earn an honest crust. Why does everyone seem to have a problem with that? I'm taking these ghastly things to the school, then I'm out of here.
Well, I don't want to go to the underground just yet. I want to see everything she can see. So, she is getting a bit more of a round tummy. Look, everything's fluffy and cuddly. It's tucked as loft and I forget the other guy's name.
A two-headed ogre. Rather rare and pretty complicated, anatomically speaking.
Talk. Speak.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Mademoiselle. Fat elf!
My name is Ivo. Who are you?
My name is Ivo, and you are...
Not Princess Ivo from the Woodland Realm.
Yep, that's me.
It's an honor, Your Highness. Although, considering the current situation, perhaps you shouldn't tell everyone who you are.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
I still don't know your name, kind sir.
Oh, excuse me, Your Serene Highness.
We'll try.
Please, call me Ivo.
My name is Zloff. That's my brother, Blout.
Blout, right.
Blout!
You're a magician, aren't you, Zloff?
Perhaps you could explain to me what's happened here. You're a mage, right, Zloff?
Mage? Me? No.
Look at Blout.
Why Zloff always say that? Zloff is mage.
Not after what happened to the other mages in this town.
What's happened?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all.
Yeah, right.
But I've definitely given up magic, and therefore I am no longer a mage.
See, being recorded. Interesting shop you have there.
Nice shop, but, a bit unusual.
Candy floss, puppies, chocolate, baby dolls.
It's dreadful. We had such a lovely inn. Subdued lighting, smoky air, and lots of alcohol. And now...
Lollies! You in! Lollies!
So the little Van Buren has transformed your inn, then?
A whole building has been transformed permanently. A little girl shouldn't have the power to do that. How does she do it?
I don't know what you mean.
Are you expiring?
You what?
Expiring?
Blout should tell council leader if people expire.
You're spying for the council leader?
Spying.
Blout's afraid the merchant council leader's daughter might turn him into a little girl with pigtails if he doesn't cooperate with her mother.
We shouldn't give away that daughter does magic. You're expiring.
No, Blout, we're not.
Then that's okay. Zloff?
Yes, Blout?
What is expiring?
It's not the word you're looking for. You shouldn't spy for the council leader, Blout.
Blout, I don't think you should spy for Van Buren. She's bad news. Surely you can see that?
Blout not want to spy, but Blout not want to be changed into Bunny Rabbit.
I was all for fleeing, but Blout wanted to stay and hide.
Quite difficult, given your size.
Blout bought disguise. No one recognized Blout.
Maybe not, but what about me?
What happened to your disguise, Blout?
Have you still got the disguise you were going to use to hide from the council leader?
Still got.
Would you give it to me?
We want it.
You want hide from council lady? You conceiving?
No, I just want to secure the disguise and hand it in at the school.
The conceiving was already done.
Otherwise, the rebels could get hold of the disguise, Blout. Do you want to be responsible for a rebel disguising themselves with your outfit?
No! Blout, good little boy. Here, take.
Okay, so you've got this
Thanks
outfit.
For chat.
You were like a beacon of light in the darkness of night, Princess.
How sweet.
I don't know what there is to talk about at the moment.
That's the disguise.
If you're surrounded by enemies, a professional disguise can make all the difference.
Let's have a look. Oh my god. Let's take it off for now.
I'm an elf and don't feel the heat and cold as much as humans do. Otherwise, elf girls' clothing would be extremely impractical.
Tell me about it.
I'm an elf and otherwise...
So we can't go further down. Right? Let me just see. Unless this thing spins around. Nope. Okay. Was he just picking the other guy's nose? Before we go through down to the underground, I just want to look around some more. That's the famous bakery. Salt pretzels, donuts with icing sugar together with hot mustard and a bit of pickled cabbage. Perfect. I think this baby is trying to influence my mind. I have no idea why she's...
I've had a craving for fish fingers with custard before.
I don't know why she wouldn't say that.
Wow, I'm glad I'm out of there. Sea stone's a dangerous place these days. But at least I can do something about it out here.
Right. Alright. Goods!
Presumably all these goods were delivered, or at least ordered, before Van Buren assumed power. I can't imagine any sane airship captain would dream of flying into Seastone right now. That crane's new. Seastone's merchants have been very creative where business is concerned.
Yeah, no kidding.
Someone once wanted to sell me a license for an apple. They didn't want the apple to belong to me, just the right to eat it. I'm pretty sure that wouldn't have ended well, had I agreed to that.
Oh, that starry sky?
It all seems quiet and peaceful looking into the starlit sky. However, there are unbelievable powers and great tragedies occurring up there. We just don't look carefully enough.
All the other worlds that we've adventured on, right, guys? Up on those worlds.
As a child, I lay on my back next to my father in the elf burrow for nights on end, observing the stars. He told me of strange worlds, and sometimes when the night sky was particularly clear, I believed that I could recognize the star turtle with my naked eyes.
Star turtle?
From up there, our problems must appear so small and insignificant. All good, all evil in this world, every elf, human, dwarf, or gnome, all lovers, every idea, each work of art, everything that's ever been built. All this exists at one tiny little moment, surrounded by darkness. And yet, it's still worth fighting for. Because our moment will only happen once.
Very poetic.
From up there, out all, and yet...
The school tower?
Wilbur wrote very excitedly to me that he, of all people, had been appointed as the first professor to the school by the Archmage. I think he was very proud, but also a bit intimidated because of his colleagues and the students. Those are the kind of worries that we'd be grateful for right now.
Yeah, well... A lotto ball. Let's just take the whole thing.
A lotto ball? Blank. Doesn't look like this has ever been used.
We're both going, Take it. No? No take. No take. Let's look at the mage tower. Look at the mage tower. Thank you.
The mage tower in Seastone is notorious. It's been said it has a mind of its own. It confuses people. It's said that visitors the town didn't like never emerged again after venturing inside.
It's not the only thing that has a mind of its own. Well, we can enter the school. Alright. Really have a look around. Mind of its own, enter the school.
I shouldn't take unnecessary risks. I'd better chat to Wilbur and the others first.
Alright then.
I shouldn't...
Alright, let's go. Let's get to the underground, the great underground. Turn all over the place. There you go.
A great disguise for the secret entrance to the underground. No one would be keen to know where the things plopped into a privy would disappear to. And the merchant was in such a fluster that he forgot the padlock.
Awesome.
Hello? Anybody there?
Hi, Vol. Is that you?
Surprised I can hear you.
Wilbur? What on earth have you been up to?
Well, you see, it's like this.
It's like this.
And then he didn't pull us up.
And then Timmy came and said you were in town. And then you called out, Wilbur, and I...
Thanks, I'm fully informed now. It's a pretty long story.
Yep, but exciting too, right? And sometimes funny and a bit sad and...
What's the next step? How are we going to change the Archmage back?
So, actually, I wanted to... Someone else should...
Wilbur was going to run away.
Oops.
What?
Wilbur. Well, now we're controlling Wilbur. I wasn't planning to escape. Not really properly.
Run away? Well, not really.
I mean, sort of.
Of course not. We can't simply leave the town to this dreadful Van Buren. And from what we know, it's likely Munkers is sneaking around here as well.
So what do we do?
First, I'm going to get you up here, I guess. Then we can work out together how to rescue the Archmage.
But Remy's right. As long as the wand still exists, there's no way we can defeat Van Buren.
Master Alistair will know what to do.
Don't rely on me. Rely on yourselves and on your friends.
What? You have to speak up.
That's what the Archmage always said. Remy believed him. That's why he took the matter into his own hands.
What's happened to Remy?
He's relying on me. I'll follow him and we'll find a way to destroy the wand. You pull the zombies and Nate up and then come up with something for the Archmage. Maybe we can also help one another a little. Maybe we can use the basket to exchange items and talk to each other through the hole.
Okay, sounds like a plan.
Go get Esther, Gulliver. Time for some fresh air.
I don't know how to thank you, Wilbur.
It's all right.
So how can...
Our second child will definitely be called Wilbur.
She's whispering.
What do you say, Nate? Want to see the stars?
He's yelling. Poodle-oop.
You wait here, Timmy.
But I can help.
You sure can. If you hear terrified screams coming from the hole, then think of something.
You are going to find Uncle Remy, aren't you?
Of course.
Look at the dark hole.
The hole is more than scary. But Remy's down there, and maybe he's injured and needs help. The hole is... But Remy... You know, somehow I can't think of anything witty to say about this rock. It's heavy, probably. Anyway. You know, it's heavy. I'll find Remy. Timmy's been through enough already. I'll find...
Now what if I just leave?
Looks like the Van Buren's girls' abominations have even found their way down here. Someone with taste couldn't bear to have this stuff around any longer and threw it away.
Search through it.
Mostly toys. Oh, what's this? A hand mirror. I'm going to take it with me. Could come in handy somewhere.
Are we going to encounter a Medusa?
A small mirror made out of some strange material. It's really smooth, like wood, but it feels different. Without Gulliver, Esther, and Nate, everything down here looks even more desolate. The three of them took everything really important up with them. And Ethel still has a watchful eye on the rest. Probably best if I leave everything as it is. Nate liked the seesaw. Probably because it was new to him. There are so many new things waiting for him up there. I almost envy him having the chance to experience it all for the first time.
Well, first he has to get up there. Say hi to Ethel.
Eventually gets to the magic school staff room where the transformed Archmage is being held captive. Unfortunately, I'm about 10 times too big to fit through the pipe. Hi, Ethel.
Hi, Ethel.
Ooh, You always have this habit of creeping up on me.
Yeah, we're good that way. I've still not quite understood this fluffy paint thing.
You and Esther did a great job of that fluffy paint. Although, I'm still not sure I understand it all.
What's so difficult to understand? Yellow and blue give you green, pink and fluffy give you fluffy pink.
There's a colour called fluffy.
Fluffy jumpers are dyed with it. Many wash powders are made almost entirely of fluffy. Oh, young people today, absolutely clueless with regards to alchemy.
Yeah, it's like a forgotten art, isn't it? It wasn't so bad working with the zombies now, was it?
You and Esther got along well together, didn't you?
Surprisingly, yes. Didn't want to eat me or anything like that. Nice person.
Good.
Gone now. I'll miss her.
You could visit her sometime.
Lots to do. But, yes, maybe.
A new friend. Well, I've decided to go after Remy down the dark hole.
I'm going after Remy. Down the dark hole.
Good, good, good. Monsieur de Dumas needs a friend.
I hope nothing bad has happened to him.
He's tough. The toughest rat I know. Wouldn't be any good in a stew. Oh, no, not him.
I have to be going, Ethel.
If you need stew, you know where to find me.
Take another advisement.
She gets startled every time I speak to her. Better I only do it when necessary. It's good to know that Ivo's up there doing her best. To be honest, she was the one who saved mine and Nate's butts when we were stuck in the wildlands.
That's right.
Basket will let Ivo and I exchange stuff. Very handy if one of us gets stuck at some point. The basket. Ivo?
What?
What are you doing in Seastone?
Not that I'm not overjoyed to see you, but what are you doing in Seastone?
I need to talk to Archmage Alistair. There's a little. Problem.
Unless it's about catching flies with your tongue, he's not going to be any help to you at the moment.
Well, the problem can wait, I hope.
Do you have any idea where Munkus might be hiding?
Munkus has completely disappeared since the fight in the staff room. Do you think he's still in town?
Yes, I fear so. Like flies to Arbor's pot, dark sorcerers are attracted to power. A little girl with seemingly unlimited magic. He'll try anything to exploit that.
And he can transform himself into anyone. Be careful about whom you trust up there.
Who says he's up here? He could be down there with you. We must both keep our eyes peeled.
She's right. Are the changes in the town really as bad as Remy told us?
Remy said that much of the city's been transformed. Is it really that bad?
Some buildings have been badly affected, but nothing that couldn't be fixed with a few flaming torches.
Burn
What's
it!
What's worse is that some people have also been transformed, and no one dares to say what they think anymore.
That is terrible!
Van Buren's intoxicated by power, worse than Joffrey. She's insane, she's going to ruin our world, and she has the means to do it.
Luckily you're here, Ivo. We'll stop them.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Joffrey. Game of Thrones reference. Blah. That's awesome. Where's Van Buren? For goodness sake, be careful of her.
Where's the council leader? Whatever you do, don't let her catch you.
It's okay. She's on her way to the elf burrow. She wants to pay my mother a visit.
Doesn't that worry you?
Nah, she'll get nowhere in the elf burrow. Elf protective magic is powerful.
So it's just a question of how long it takes Van Buren to figure that out.
She'll be furious. It's best we're no longer here by the time she gets back.
I have to get going. Don't get caught.
Good luck. Keep your ears stiff.
Keep your ears stiff? That's a new one.
Ivo?
Yes.
Nothing. I just wanted to know if you were there.
Right. I'm here.
Ivo's there. Everything's fine. Ivo?
Yeah.
Nothing. Ivo.
So what if someone else has to use that toilet? Yeah, let's see if we can get down there.
The rope has served me well twice already. Maybe it'll hold up for a third time, too.
Should we tie it around the rock or tie it around the pipe? Well, probably going to be the rock. Because we can already interact with the rock.
I know from experience that rope can hold my weight. Let's just hope it hasn't changed its mind.
He keeps taking off the hat I put on him. There you go.
Okay.
Down we go.
The time had to come sooner or later. Ah!
Yeah.
Another one.
What?
For years, no one visits, and now all this activity.
More books? So much for the stealthy approach. Hello? I am Wilbur.
Hello? Who's there? I'm Wilbur,
said the ugly dwarf, whilst peering into the darkness.
He's not
hey,
a dwarf.
I'm not a dwarf, I'm a gnome. Mum says I'm a handsome little fella, too.
He said defensively, but this did not impress the darkness much. Next, the dwarf said...
Next, he said, Who are you? Come into the light.
Who are you? And why don't you come into the light so I can see you?
Why are you narrating my life?
Well, we could, but we just don't want to. We are gods. We can do anything.
Gods?
You're gods?
He froze, as if struck by a bolt of lightning, whilst the implications of this danced wildly around his head.
Actually, no, not really.
But you must. You are speaking to gods.
Prove it.
What exactly are implications?
Mm-hmm. Hey, two cannibals are eating a clown, and one says to the other, "He tastes a bit funny."
You books are drunk.
Oh, do be quiet. I'm trying to create atmosphere here.
Isn't it about time for a riddle?
It really is pretty dark here, isn't it?
Not that I have anything against creepy voices from the dark, but maybe we could have a little light here?
Why is it dark? And what could you do to make it light?
I don't
know. The young hero stood in a beam of light, surrounded by the deepest darkness. And the voices said,
two trolls look up into the night sky. One asks the other, what do you think? Is there life on the moon? And the other replies, well, of course, there's a light on, isn't there?
Fantastic.
If you really are gods, then why don't you get some light sorted out?
If you're gods, then can't you just say something like, let there be light, and it gets all bright in here?
Two trolls are looking up into the night sky, and one says to the other, what do you think?
We heard
this
one.
Is there life on the moon?
Not again.
Just told us this.
Of course we could create some light. Or it could simply just be light in this cave. But where's the challenge in that?
But,
said the little dwarf.
Why does everything always have to be so complicated?
And stamped his foot on the ground.
Say what?
You can stamp his foot.
You have to stamp your foot on the ground.
I have to?
What kind of gods are you?
Well, we are...
Wait! He has to create light first.
I thought you were going to create light. I'm looking for a friend, small, hairy...
Did a rat in a hat pass through here?
That too.
Asked the gnome in a brave voice. He, however, didn't know at this point that he would be leaving the caves without his friend.
Great.
You know something about Remy?
That's what one calls foreshadowing. It's a device used to keep the audience entertained.
What audience?
Showing something other than complete darkness might also be helpful.
He's got to solve the riddle first. So what's with Remy? Was he here? Where did he go?
Oh, I've got another one. One politician says to the other, I don't know why no one likes us. We don't do anything.
Nah.
And what exactly has that got to do with the story?
I'm just going to take a look, a little look around here. See you later.
Thank you for the conversation. I'll look around a bit.
Not without any light.
Hey, two cannibals are eating a clam, and one says to the other, he tastes a bit funny.
Bad jokes and a bad memory. I know that one already.
That joke? I think you told it earlier.
I know you told it
earlier.
That's
absolutely no reason for not repeating it again and again and again.
Hey, it's a good one.
It's a good one. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. Stay tuned when we explore the dark hole and maybe we'll see these gods. Thanks for watching. See you next time in a Bang Bang Boogie, and don't stop the boogie.